Hello and welcome back to yet another exciting session that we have lined up for you all. Before we move ahead, I would like to take this opportunity to thank our partners Z5, Infobip, Financial Express Brand Wagon, Flipkart, Jagran New Media, Telesign, ShareChat, Blink Digital, and Nielsen. Without further ado, let's start with our upcoming case study, Woot and Voiro, a success story. To present the case study, we have with us Ms. Kavita Shenoy, founder and CEO, Voiro, and Mr. Satish Sawant, Associate Vice President, Operations, Vicom 18 Media. Over to you, Ms. Kavita.
Thank you. And thank you, IMEI, for having us here today. Hi, Satish. How are you?
Hey, hi. Hi, Kavita. I'm good. How are you?
I like the new lockdown look that you're rocking right now.
Yeah, that's new in the trend right now.
Nice. So today's session is Digital for All. It's quite a broad topic, and I've listened to a couple of the keynotes earlier today. And I think, you know, what Woot and Voiro are doing right now are bang on, because, you know, like Brian Martin was saying earlier today, marketing is obsessed with data, right? And addressable targeting is the future for most marketing. And, you know, Satyan was talking about the fact that direct publisher relationships is the way to go to be able to leverage and mitigate risks that actually surround the entire, mire of what happens in digital advertising in terms of, unsafe content and whatnot, right? And the lack of transparency. So I think both of these work in favor of Woot. Hang on. Just a minute. All right. So Woot and Voiro have been associated now for 2017, a little bit over a year after it started, right? And I think it was because of two things. One was because of the fact that Voiro was extremely persistent in our sales. But more importantly, I think, and you will agree with me on this, that Woot had extremely futuristic thinking that they put into place right in the beginning, where they wanted to keep data at the center of all their conversations. And I think that's something that currently continues as well within your organization. Isn't that right?
Absolutely, Kavita. I mean, the way we look at the data and the way we look at getting the data out of from whatever ad server we are working with, not only for our own internal consumption, but also for the advertisers pursual. So it's for being like just a traditional company to a data-driven company, it takes little time. And we, from the way we have grown from 2017 to 2020, we have seen a tremendous growth in terms of the way we used to execute earlier and the way we are executing right now. Because for us, having a conjecture conversation is on a different part, but having a data-led conversation, which is at the heart of everyone, because that's where we all come from. From CPM to CPC to CPT, and now if you see everything about the data, about the audiences, and that's where we want to be, because we want to be ahead of curve. And that will be the key for successful for any tech organization in this industry.
Very true, very true. And you know, one of the single biggest problems in an ad-led monetization strategy is that ad inventory is ephemeral, right? If you don't make use of it right then and there, it's gone. It's gone forever. And the more inventory you have, it's more important to be scientific and manage your workflow and your data analysis well, because you don't want to be sitting on a ton of unorganized information where you're trying to trawl through it. So having started off right at the beginning in itself has put you ahead of the curve already. And this is something that you continue to do.
Absolutely. I mean, the way, if you see, I mean, a lot of events, a lot of series which comes on Woot platform recently. I mean, the Big Boss will be coming very soon, just a month away from now. So man, that kind of scale, and in terms of demand as well as supply, it's a data crunching job, because it's not just understanding where the revenue coming in, but also to understand what is the inventory we are generating and how we can match that to get more and the better yield of each and every impression or each and every inventory which we are generating.
So
it's very important to have this kind of technology in place. I mean, I'm pretty much, for me, it's like having a expertise within the team or outsourcing that to someone who has a team of experts would be a much better thing, because those are the people who actually think day in, day out for that particular, because that's their job. And that's where investing a technology platform for this factor is pretty much key. I mean, that's what I was very, very much keen on. So which can give us the insight about the revenues, about the audiences, about the inventory on a day-to-day basis, which we breathe in, breathe out.
Right. And if you listen to that keynote speech today in the morning by Brian, right, he ended the whole thing by saying that marketing activity has moved beyond human capability and now has become a software problem, right? And that's pretty much what we're doing right now. We're dealing with machines talking to each other. And the fact that advertising in itself has moved into this realm of, multiple sources of demand, the death of third-party cookies, and the huge focus on making sure that your first-party data is protected and well managed and maintained starts to become a very formidable problem for you to solve, and also something of an opportunity for you in the future. Because if you need to get to addressable targeting, from being a traditional company to a digital company, making sure that you're actually putting your stake firm down to the ground. Data is definitely the way to go, and making sure that it reaches each and every one of your users and in your workforce is, I think, something that is de rigueur right now. Right? So when we started off, right, one of the single biggest challenges that you have, and I think you continue to have right now, is that you don't have a single view of your revenue horizon in real time. And revenue, and I'm pretty sure people listen to us right now, revenue is definitely not an open and shut data point. It's always rife with various questions. Isn't that right, Satish?
So that's an absolute fact of any data-driven company, because the time when we started, it was absolutely on the just a campaign management tool where we just have to upload the campaign and see the campaigns are loading. But reconciling that particular revenue which were generating on a single dashboard was an absolute pain, because most of the thing was happening on the Excel. And for a leader, sort of for a data driven company like us, it's pretty much important to have a single view, single screen where we can see a lot of other insights. I mean, all the other major or broad insights which helps to take a business decisions to understand. Maybe it's a national, it's a region wise trend, category wise trend, and maybe a genre wise trend. How we are seeing, where are we getting business wise trend? So that's pretty important for any business, because when I get up in the morning, for first thing is for me is to just to go to Voido dashboard, log into it, just see the numbers which you are driving yesterday and what is the number to month to date, and that's where my day starts. And I really, that's where we wanted to be when we started, and now at least we are somewhere near to that.
Yes, so, of course.
That is a challenge we're facing, and I think we are slowly coming over that challenge now.
Yeah. So revenue, like I was saying, is not an open and shut data point, right? It's always tagged with how do I make more? Where am I losing my revenue? What is at risk? Who's coming new? And these are the kinds of things that we also address in our special analytics email out that goes out to everybody in the morning. And, we like to say that mail actually tells you what horrors of the day await you in automated fashion, right? Instead of going and trying to trawl through it in the morning. So I think this has been a challenge, and I think it's not an open and shut thing. It's something that is going to be a continuously revisited topic, because the revenue horizon and what constitutes revenue and what could make revenue for you is changing as it goes, because that's the fundamentals of every content company, right? You are as good as your content, and today you're as good as your audience, and that's something that you really want to lock in on and make sure that everybody understands your value proposition. So with Voido, what we want to do is that we want to accelerate every company to be data first. And like we see with Voido right now, it's not an easy task. It's not a task that you can turn around in 3 weeks, 8 weeks, or 10 days. It's something that is more of a culture that you need to develop within an organization, and that we see running very strongly at Voido. Voido has managed to maintain themselves as a very lean, mean organization, with every person in their job being a specialist and not a generalist. And so therefore, the information that actually reaches them is pertinent to their job. It's pertinent to making sure that they're supercharging their job on a daily basis. So each person is, having relevant conversations with their advertisers that are sunk with a lot of insights, right? And Satish has been helming a lot of these things to make sure that he translates these needs of all of his people up and down the food chain to make sure that the data reaches them in a manner that is palatable and valuable. We worked with Voot in four phases, right? And these phases are not, like I said, 3 days, 10 days. It's over years and months and quarters and hours and heartbreak and tears, right? So we've implemented a workflow which basically is driving a data-driven culture within the organization. It is not as easy as saying, I implemented a workflow. It is difficult, and I'm sure that Satish will stand testament to that. And yes, go ahead, Satish.
Yeah, Kavita, I mean, I totally agree with you on the hard work which has gone from your side as well as from the our side to make things where we are currently on that. I mean, for us, it was like workflow automation was one of the key objective when we started with Voiro, where we want to minimize the effort which going from the operation people to take the campaign live. But today, where we are setting it at the audience intelligence, sales numbers completely taken care on that, plus the data analysis, which we are doing it just to not only for our internal consumption, but also for making our advertisers, I mean, just providing our advertisers with a better version of audience, which we are delivering on. So that really has come to, we have come a long way ahead from where we started. And I think from here, we are the way we are seeing it going together, it's another journey altogether, because it's completely into the advanced phase of data automation. And having a different set of segments or different set of insights on that. So probably, I mean, that's a different story altogether, which we'll be building. Because if you see 50% of our, I mean, when we started, like 50% of our operation bandwidth goes in campaign management, 30% on reporting and 20% on doing data analysis. So I see the 50% of, which is the core job of account manager, is being now completely 80% of that job is getting covered by that, because the reporting data analysis part is completely taken by the system right now.
Yeah.
You don't have to intervene much on that. So that's really us a lot to invest that energy into different tasks and increase the productivity of the individuals.
Very true. Very true. And the underlying factor of all of this is that Woot has been one of the first publishers and that pioneered in making sure that they were able to get all of their server log information into one single place. And you are able to look at your information at a unique level. And you're able to give your advertisers 100% transparency as to where you're getting that information from. It's not an estimated number, it's not an indexed number. It's actually a true to form number that you're actually giving them. And you're investing in big data technology behind this that makes it look easy and simple on the outside, but there's a lot of underlying work that goes into ensure that you are giving your advertisers the best bang for their buck. So I think from that, one of the major wins that we've had with Woot, and we are excited to see what the future holds, is one is on audience insights and the other one is on sales intelligence, like Satish was saying. The audience insight is basically it's quite fancy. It's a sales forecasting capability that you're able to layer insights across content, inventory, audience types, etc. at a very unique level, right? And when I say at a unique level, I mean at an individual level, which means that this data, you cannot shore it all up. It's a lot of computing power. It requires a lot of data engineering to go into it, etc. And the output is simple, because at the end of the day, what happens is that this capability is taken to drive sales in a pre-sales situation. And sales intelligence is to be able to highlight to sales and operations the potential and incremental value and revenue opportunities that you can actually position to your advertisers during the campaign as well, right? So you can drive on-point ROI for advertisers. So with both of these, we pretty much sandwich the beginning and the end of a sales cycle. And as you know, most sales cycles within a publisher is cyclical. And that's something that we really want to make sure that we continue on a regular basis, right? So what is the future looking like with Woot and Voiro, Satish? What do you think that the industry should be doing based on what your thoughts are?
See, I mean, to be very honest, the way industry is growing, as I mentioned, it's all about the data audiences. So for us, being at a technology company, data will be our core at heart. And that's something which we really wanted to leverage on, because first party data is the data we always have, which any company should have, and leverage that in some form or other using the technology platform or by creating an internal data management platform. That's a key factor, because Big Boss coming on board right now, Gone Games is another series which is in launch right now. Because we are not just looking at the monetization from the revenue or inventory part, but also from the subscription business, which is going at multiple fold every month in this lockdown period. But in terms of technology, in terms of investment, which we are doing is pretty much on the data side, where we are seeing the customer segmentation, understanding the behavior of the user with the different metrics which we are getting on board. And this will be definitely a game changing for us, because it's in this era, it's very important. I mean, the way our audience or the user are getting mature, it's important to understand their preference, show them right ad or right content at right time, at right place. That's a key right. to any kind of engagement with the user. And that's where we are working towards it, by having some kind of recommendation engine or having a data management platform in-house build, which we are working on. I mean, it's already in finalized stage. Yep. We should have something. And I think that data flowing inside the ad server, along with the some kind of data crunching, which we'll be doing it from Boiro, will be a key success for us in next 6 to 8 months. And I really want, I'm looking forward, Boiro team, to like, I mean, the way we are being doing, it's not just not a vendor or organization relationship, but it's a partnership which we have built in last 3-4 years, where we have taken projects in as an independent project, as a collective effort, and we have delivered on. So that will be a key phase for us. So probably, I mean, the data thing will be much more important for us going forward.
Very true. Thank you, Satish. We have a question, which is, based on the automation and analysis done by us, what should be the ideal marketing mix for brands in these times? I think, you know, if you've been watching, who asked this question, you've been watching the keynotes and, you know, what's happening in the marketing conclave, you know, you need to have a combination of both the platforms as well as direct partnerships and direct, direct publishers, because one is your platforms do give you scale at the end of the day, but direct publishers, which is publishers like Voot and the rest of the OTT platforms, actually hold the reins on content and also are able to ring fence a lot of audiences. And the future being with the entire first party data aspect, going to larger OTT players will actually help you make sure that you're able to address your target audience, right? I think the second question you should try and take up, Satish.
So how should a brand maintain the difference between the branding and marketing while conveying the story to the consumer through video marketing? Yeah, that's a very interesting question. And as a marketer, as a brand, what's important for us to make a difference between the branding and the performance activity. So branding is pretty much for the user to get the new users on board, just to show them what we have done. And secondly, in terms of the performance, where the acquisition of those users to consume more content. So there are two different. So when we are conveying this kind of marketing activity, it's very important to have a different marketing messages, whether it's acquiring the user or it's about engagement of the existing user on the platform with the content which is ongoing. So push notification, email notification to the existing user. So those are the different metrics which we actually track it on our end. So making a different, I mean, different campaign altogether for branding and performance does help to maintain that balance between the acquisition and the engagement.
Right. So what are the plans coming up in terms of content for Voot in the next couple of months, in the next quarters?
We have a couple of interesting plans because of the lockdowns, most of the things got pushed out. Right. But I think Gone Games is one of the new series has come. I should not be quoting this, but actually Asur Part 2, somewhere we have started shooting.
I'm dying for Asur Part 2.
Yeah, I mean, we have got a lot of good reviews, and even from our advertiser, everybody's willing to see the Part 2. So that will be, the production will start soon. Big Boss, it's going to be much bigger, because last, just to quote the numbers, we had 1.5 billion views only on Big Boss in last season. And we are expecting to grow that number by 35-40% this year. So that's a big win for us. And comparing, I think all the three major events in the OTT platform are coming on the same time, IPL, KBC and Big Boss. So probably there might be a hit on the TV viewership, but we are expecting at least online viewership while will go up, because we have the option to view anytime, anywhere we want. So going to be pretty interesting phase for next 3 months for us.
Nice. I think the next couple of months and the next couple of quarters is going to really define a lot of things for us in the industry as well. And first party data and making sure that your data is in intact, making sure that you're able to reach advertisers and users alike in leveraging technology, because everything is becoming programmatic, whether it is sales,